Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We apologize for this technical problem. Well, the CNN network have chose Egypt as one of the top places to go to in the year 2021. As soon as the travel restrictions are lifted after the COVID-19, we will talk now about tourism in Egypt, as a report published recently puts Egypt among the 21 destinations recommended for the new year travel. To shed more light on this, we have the pleasure to have this phone with Mr. Tariq El-Sharif, member of the Tourist Chambers Federation. Welcome, Mr. Tariq.
Yes, hi, good afternoon to you. Hello,
Mr. Tariq.
Yes, good afternoon.
Good afternoon to you, sir. Well, how did you read the report published about Egypt as one of the most important destinations in the year 2021?
Well, this is not news, because, I mean, Egypt has always been among the top destinations for tourism worldwide, and I'm not surprised that it will be among the top 20 in 2021, not only for tourism, but also for stability and being a very good and fast growth economy. So it is not really a surprise. I would maybe look at it as maybe it will be the destination in 2021.
Yes. So how can we take benefit of this report and promote for tourism in Egypt?
Well, I'm sorry, this, it doesn't sound, I cannot hear you properly.
Okay. Mr. Sharif, how can we take benefit of this report and promote for tourism in Egypt?
Okay, well, I think it is now time, we've had the downtime, and that was a good time for us to rebuild and restructure our infrastructure.
Yes.
So it is now time to take advantage of the rebound. Hotels are getting ready. We should have also taken the time to train our staff and make sure that they are developed and their skills have been sharpened.
Yes.
So we, being among the top destinations on that report, that means that there's an eye being kept on Egypt, and we need to make sure that we are there with the services, and there have been a lot of discoveries recently being announced in global or international press conferences.
Yes.
So all this together, we need to make sure that we are there on the platform, we are there in international affairs, even if they are virtual, but we still have to be there with full force.
Yes, Mr. Sharif, in light of this report, what are your expectations for the promoting of tourism in Egypt in the year 2021?
Well, although I mean, no one has a crystal ball, because back in November, everybody was pretty sure that quarter one 2021 would be a rebound. However, with the second wave of the COVID-19, that may be a little bit, but I would see a lot of information things back by Easter, somewhere around. But I'm very confident that we will be taking off and back again to full swing.
Yes. So, Mr. Sharif, now Egypt is hosting the handball World Cup championship for men, and actually the inauguration ceremony, it was inaugurated by President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi and under the auspices of President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi. How did you follow the inauguration ceremony, and what is the importance of Egypt hosting such an event for promoting for tourism, showing that Egypt is a safe country that, and also is facing the challenge of the COVID-19 that is under control until now?
Well, I think this is a great message to the world, that we are in Egypt with our leadership, with the people working in this a great event. It's a World Cup for men. I think it's a great message to the world that we are safe, stable, we know what we're doing, and we're moving ahead. The message itself, by holding it in time, without having to postpone it, That is another strong message that we are in control and we can manage.
Yes.
So far, I've been following the game. The opening ceremony was just fantastic. And it is nothing less than international events that we see, like the World Cup and others, or the Olympics even. And it, again, sends a very strong message to the world.
Yes, sir. So, Mr. Sharif, now we are all waiting for the soon-to-be-opened the Grand Egyptian Museum. So how do you see this opening that would be very soon? We hope so. Its impact, I mean, on the tourism industry.
Well, I like to use the word orchestra or symphony, and I think we are playing a great symphony of glory here, with all the discoveries, with the opening soon to open the great museum, with the World Cup, with our economical growth. I think this is being brilliantly orchestrated efforts, and it's just sending a very strong message to the world that come and visit us.
Yes.
Everybody around the world would love to come see the Egypt and the monuments, and I think we're giving them a great opportunity.
Yes.
And I'm sure there is arrangements for a grand opening, and it's going to be an international grand opening.
Yes.
For the museum.
Yes, yes. So, Mr. Sharif, there were also a lot of discoveries in the year 2020, and yesterday actually there was an announcement by the Ministry of Tourism and Antiquities of more discoveries in the Saqqara and more coffers were discovered. How do you see the importance of the latest discoveries in promoting for tourism in Egypt?
Well, I think this is, again, we just need to make use of that globally. So the announcement is great. Conference with international reporters, and just send them that we are yet still discovering more and more issues. And that is also an invitation for those who came before to come and something different. Because, I mean, that is every time you come to visit Egypt, something new to find. This the last discovery in December was great, and then it was announced at that time in the press conference that there is more to come in the beginning of 2021.
Yes.
So here we go, and I'm sure there will be more.
Yes. Yes. So, Mr. Sharif, also Egypt in the year 2020, under the directives of Prince Abdel Hassisi, several museums were opened, and there were lots of restorations to archaeological sites in Egypt. How do you see the importance of this?
Of course, it's very important, because for years and decades, tourism was very limited to the classical destination, like
yes.
Cairo, Luxor, Aswan, and that's it, and maybe sometimes Alexandria. But now we're giving an opportunity for more tourism in different governorates, because you can go and see the monuments in its own hometown. So the museums that have been opened are a reflection of working very hard on the infrastructure of tourism. And it's not about just inviting people to come, but you have an infrastructure for them to come and enjoy. So I see it in the direction of building the infrastructure as very solid base for tourism to come, not only in Cairo, but you can expand to other governments.
Yes, yes. And now there are, a plan to return the path of the Holy Family in Egypt to also to promote for tourism in Egypt. How do you read it?
Well, I think this has been very well overdue, because this has been discussed for years.
Yes.
And there's no doubt that there is a part of the holy trip was in Egypt, and
yes.
There's a lot of destinations, and I think it is kind of overdue, but I'm sure it will come on the priorities of the government to support this path. There's a lot of infrastructure that needs to be done in certain locations, and this is the way I see it, is attracting a new kind of tourism. is not only for those who are like Christians, but it is a religious tourism that will attract more people from around the globe.
Yes. So, Mr. Sharif, we saw several pictures as Egypt is hosting the World Handball Championship for Men. We saw several pictures for the teams participating in this championship in Egypt, like, for example, the Egyptian, the German team. We saw them sitting, and in the background, we saw the pyramids of Giza. So, such pictures famous teams participating in this championship, and also the pictures that we saw before for icons around the world and for politicians and leaders from around the world taking pictures with the pyramids of Giza. How do you see the importance of these pictures, and how can we get or take benefit of it to promote for tourism in Egypt?
Well, you know that there's 32 countries this year playing the game in the World Cup for the first time, and that's a 31 plus Egypt. So you can imagine that there's a 31 teams from around the globe taking pictures like that, and then you multiply that by how many members of the delegation, like the team, the support, the subsidiaries, the coaches, the doctors, and then you can imagine also the power of social media. So those people are communicating back home through social media, through Facebook, Twitter, whatever. So you can imagine the significance of these pictures for people telling their family back home, like the Germans or the Spanish or so on, we are safe, we are happy, we're enjoying our time, and we are playing games in Egypt. Yes. That is great publicity. It is outstanding publicity, and I'm sure it will have a payback as soon as tourism is back.
Yes, I thank you very much for your time, for your valuable information, Mr. Tariq Sharif, member of the Touristic Chambers Federation. Thank you very much for joining us over the phone. Ladies and gentlemen, a short break, and I'm going to be back with you.